So paano po ba talaga, technically speaking, as a parang guru po ng ganitong mga klaseng situation, paano niyo po ba i-manage yung work life, 'di ba, yung trabaho, yung buhay, when you yourself is dealing with depression?
Well, when you know you're going through something that's extremely agitating and aggravating, and it's already affecting your health, your personal and work relationships, kailangan gumawa ka ng plano. Diba? Yung pag-assess mo ng situation is complemented by that. Ano yung gagawin mo afterwards? Or is it something that you cannot take yourself out from? Like, oh, kapamilya mo or katrabaho mo, then find a creative outlet. Kailangan you have to keep yourself busy so that yung balance makuha mo with regard your inner life. Kailangan bigyan mo ng time yung sarili mo because no one else will take care of you. The best person to look after you is yourself. And then you have more to give to the people around you. So how will you enjoy the life that you're aiming for if you're not, if you don't have the help that you need to enjoy everything? It's responsible living eh. Kasi maraming maaapektuhan if you don't address these matters. So kung alam mo na may mga stressors ka, identify them. Stress comes from the outside. Mm-hmm. Yung depression is already the stress that's internalized. Mm-hmm. Prolonged na nga eh. So whatever you're going to do, you have to aim for a more productive and creative life. And hindi mo mababago yung mga tao at sitwasyon na nangyayari sa buhay mo. But definitely, you are most in control of how you're going to live your own life.
Pero Ms. Sheila, when it comes to depression, sino ang pwede mag-diagnose?
Yeah, if you know that there's that certain feeling of longing or melancholy or agitation and it's prolonged, nakaka-apekto na sa mga regular life activities mo, then seek medical assistance. And normally, the intervention would be therapy, psychotherapy, o kaya may mga medication din naman, but do not self-medicate. Hindi yan masyado makakatulong. Kailangan mo marinig from one or two medical experts or professionals how to go about it. Kasi even if we're equipped with all the knowledge na nakuha natin sa Google or sa books, diba? We have our blind spots eh. Hindi natin madadiagnose kung ano yung pinagdadaanan natin. So Carl Jung said, no, only wounded physicians can heal. So once that condition is acknowledged and the right tools are learned and the actions are taken, the person usually comes out stronger, more beautiful. Pero yung reality na there are personalities who are really prone to melancholy or depression, hindi natin pwedeng i-take for granted. Hindi naman lahat ng tao nag-i-enjoy dahil nakapanood sila ng sine or nakapag-shopping sila. There are individuals who find their balance by being quiet, by immersing themselves in that feeling of melancholy and loneliness. So, i-respect natin yung mga ganyang situation and let's not invalidate the feelings of individuals. Baka naman yung asawa mo or yung katrabaho mo, nag-iisa, feeling mo naman, depressed na siya, sabihin mo, oh, malungkot ka na naman, ano na naman yung issue mo? Gusto lang niya mag-isa.
Puro yan.
Diba? We have to be mindful not only of our actions but of the words that we're using. Yeah, one word, one line can definitely make a big difference, especially at times like this, when it's when we're so open to information and yet we don't know so much.
Wow. Thank you so much.
Thank you po.
Para sa mga interesado magpa i-avail yung inyong mga services, saan ba sila pwedeng lumapit?
Yeah, Kikay, they can reach us at 894-5588, 0917-853-5588, talkshop.ph. We are located in Makati, Salcedo Street, Legazpi Village. So for classes and workshops and schedule for assessment, feel free to call. We're open from Mondays through Saturdays.
Thank you.
Thank you.